Hi guys, today I'll be sharing with you a quick easy trick by the help of which you can find squares of any number between 0 or rather 1 to 100. So between 1 to 100, if you have to find the squares of any number, you have to, there's a requisite actually. This the prerequisite is you have to know the numbers on the square of the numbers between 1 to 30. If you know the squares of the numbers between 1 to 30, then you can find any the square of any number from 30 100. So with this numbers ranging from 31 to 100 rather, I will be dividing this group of numbers between 31 to 100 into three groups. So the first group will come from starting from 31 to 50. Okay. The second group will be having the numbers between 50 and 80, or rather 50 is over here, so let's write at 51. 51 to 80, and the third group will be having the numbers between 81 to 100 or even greater than 100. Okay, let's move forward with our first part, that is 31 to 50. That is how we can find the squares of number between 31 to 50. For that, if you have to find these numbers between 31 to 50, let us take an example and let's see how we can solve it. Let's take 41 as the example. That is, you have to find the square of the number 41. If the number is between 31 to 50, what you have to do is you have to deduct a certain number from 50 in order to reach to that number. That is, in case our example is 41, so 50 minus 9 will give us 41. In case in other way, you can say that what number will be deducted from 50 to reach this number? That is 9. Now this 9 square, that is 81, will form our last two digits of the number 41 square. So 9 square is 81. So 81 will come over here, and this first two digit can be deducted from 25. This 9 along with the sign has to be taken over here, minus 9 will form 16. Now guys, let me tell you one thing, that in order to calculate the first two digits over here for the numbers between 31 to 50, 25 is the base, and for the last two digits, 50 is the base. So you see 41 square is 1681. Let's see another example. So let's log everything. Okay. Let us take 36 square. So 36 is nothing but 50 minus 14. So what guys will be the last two digits of the number when 36 is square? That is 14 square. That is 196 is 14 square. If we take 96 in here, 1 will be carried. Now this one has to be added to the number 14 is deducted from 25. The rule is for first two digits, 25 minus this number which has been deducted from 50 in order to get this number, plus if any carryovers are there. There will be cases when there will be no carryover, so you just have to take this part only. So, but since we are having the carryover, so it will be minus 13 plus 1 minus 13, minus 14 plus 1 minus 13, minus plus 25, that is 12. So 12 96 is 36 square. Now, as we have seen two examples, let's move forward to our second part, second type of numbers, that is ranging between 51 to 80. Okay, let's drop. Now, 51 to 80. What we can do for these numbers? Guys, it's very simple. Again, the same logic, if the number, suppose for example, 54 square we have to find. 54 is nothing but 50 plus 4 square. 54 plus 4 whole square, or you just forget about the whole square, just concentrate on the number, that is 50 plus 4. So the last two digits of this number will be having this 4 square, is for sure, that is 16. And what about the first? And the first two digits can be achieved by the fact that when this number is added to 25, this number is what? This number is that number, the same number which when added to 50 will give me the number whose square I have to find. So here 25 plus 4 will give us 29, so this will come as 29 16. Let's try with another example. So let's take a number even bigger. Let's just suppose we have to find the square of 70. So 70 square. 70 is how much? More than 50. 50 plus 20 is 70. So obviously, you can see the last two digits of 70 square will be comprising of 20 square. And that is what? 20 square is 400. Right? So this two zeros over here will just be coming down as the last two digits. Now this 4 will be the carryover. What about the carryover, guys? You have to add 25 plus the number which has to be added to 50 in order to get reach out to this number. That is 20 plus the carryover. This will give us the first two digits, and that is nothing but 49. So you see, guys, it's so much simple. I'm explaining to you guys so that because of which it is taking maybe 30 seconds or 20 seconds, but trust me, guys, when you will be doing it in practice, it's just much, much faster than that. It takes even 5 seconds to calculate the whole thing. You just calculate the 20 square is this. You just write over here the two zeros, and then in your mind, the back of your mind, you will be doing this calculation. 25 plus 20, that is 45 plus 4, 49. So you see how simple is it? Let's move forward with our third type of numbers, that is between 81 to 100. Okay, now in order to find these numbers between 81 to 100, we have to apply another technique. That is not taking 50 or 25 as the best, but taking 100 as the best. Okay, so 92, which is greater than 81 or is less than 100, we have to take 100 as the best. That is, by how much is 92 less than 100? That is, by 8. Or in other words, we can again say by what number has to be deducted from 100 in order to reach 92, that is 8. So again, 92 square will be having 4 digits. The last 2 digits will be nothing but 8 square, that is 64. But how much will be this first 2 digits? This first 2 digits, for this case, guys, we will not considering 25 as the best, as we have done in cases between for numbers between 31 to 50 or 51 to 80. Okay. But we'll be taking, here we have taken 25 as the base. But here we'll be taking the number itself as the base. That is 92 minus this number which has been deducted from 100 will give us the first two digits. That is 84. So 8464 will be the square of 92. Let's check it with our calculator. 92. 8464. You see, guys? So is it difficult to calculate this square of any number between 10 seconds? 5 to 10 seconds? It isn't. It's very much faster and it's a powerful technique. Now, in case you have given, suppose a number between, suppose a number greater than 100, suppose 104. How will you be doing it? There is a technique again. 104 is 100 plus 4. So obviously the last two digit will be 4 squared, that is 16. And what about the first two digit? The first two digit is nothing but this number when added to this number. Remember, guys, for the numbers which are between 31 to 80, you have to take 25 as the base for the first two digits and 50 as the base for the last two digits. And in case of numbers which are greater than 81, even are greater than 100 and that are also greater than 100, the base for the first two digit is the base for the first two digit is the number itself, and the base for the last two digit is 100. So if we are taking this 104, so the first two digit or that is the last two digit will be 16, and the first two digit will be 104 plus 4, that is nothing but 108. So let us calculate it, guys. So 108. It is that much simpler. We are doing this big calculations like we used to do with our childhood, you know, school level, like 104 into 100. Just forget these things. We have answer in our hand within seconds. Who cares about all this? So thank you guys for watching. Hope you subscribe to my channel, and I will be posting videos like this about quicker maths and all in the coming weeks. Yeah, thank you guys, and please do share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.